Welcome back to the channel. In this week's video, we are gonna paint this tank. If you haven't seen the video where we got our generator, I'll tag it up here in an iCard, but we talked about this fuel tank and that we got it, 500 gallon fuel tank. It used to be white. Well, we took it in and had it sandblasted because it was a horrible paint job. Somebody just kind of painted over a bunch of rust, and I wanted to make sure the tank was in good shape before we put 500 gallons of fuel in there and leaked it all over the ground. So we had it sandblasted. We just picked it up from the company. We're about to put it in the garage and repaint it. The reason we had the tank sandblasted is we were able to pick up this tank for $500, and it cost us $400 to sandblast it. So we're into the tank $900. To buy this tank new is over $2,000, closer to $3,000 here in Alaska. So we're way money ahead to pick up this tank used, sandblast it, and put a brand new coating on it. It's gonna last for years. We gotta get an epoxy primer that I'm gonna spray on it. And so it should be quite interesting. The ladder is in the back of the truck and the tank is right here. So I gotta get the tractor out. I can't obviously lift this, but we gotta get the tractor out, which I've had it heating up in the back because I believe, let's see what the temperature is. Yeah, it's less than 10 degrees out right now. So the tractor's frozen. Hopefully it'll start. Let's see.
Well, you said you've been warming the tractor up?
Yeah, it's been plugged in for a while. Like a while, is it a couple days?
We'll see if she starts right up.
I don't know.
Well, pretty cold out here.
It's one thing to have the engine oil warm, but the hydraulic fluid is gonna be cold. Time to get cold.
Taking your gloves off?
Yeah. Doing it by braille. Woohoo, I got it. My knees are frozen. You know one thing I've noticed about us? We never wear the proper clothes.
What should you be wearing today?
Huh?
What should you be wearing today?
I don't know, some insulated coveralls.
Ooh, that's
that'd be
nice.
Ideal. I don't know, what do you think you should wear today? I mean, snow boots, for instance. I'm wearing hiking shoes. maybe some under layers or something like that. You know what I mean? Just stuff to stay warm. 9 times out of 10, I just freeze and I'm like, oh well. Now we just have to pull the tarp off.
Pull it off and see if she'll fire up.
I'm gonna take the tarp off, hopefully flip it.
Oh, okay.
At least that's my thought.
There we go. It's heavy with that snow in there.
I just feel like looking at the smoker.
Yeah, let's see. It's got a nice smoky look to it now.
Oh, nice and, yeah, it's starting to golden up inside
it
there.
It smells good. Look at the gold on the top.
Oh, that does smell good. Oh, man.
Yummy.
Woo, that smells good. Oh, the old hydraulics.
They work?
They work, but they're cold. Slow. Good way to break things. All right. It's just cold out. feels way colder than what the thermometer's saying.
Yeah, it does.
Because I just want to protect the concrete when I spray. I'm going to be using a epoxy primer, which is going to be a two-part primer that I have to mix up. But we're in the rental in the other side of the duplex because, well, we don't have a tenant anymore. Our oldest daughter will be moving up here, which we're excited about because we're going to get two of our grandkids at the end of the month, this month?
Yep.
Yeah, well, they'll be moving in, I guess, the
about
beginning
March.
Of March.
Yeah.
But anyways, we're super excited about that, but for now, I got a garage that I can paint in that's warm and clean.
Metal pole had been one more inch, it would not have made it. Just one more inch and it would have been not doable to get it in here and get it painted. So we got pretty lucky.
That thing's kind of heavy.
Yeah, it is.
Solid steel.
You couldn't have made it in here if this was one more inch higher.
I know.
Not even like.
That's crazy.
It was crazy.
Oh, there we go.
All right, you got your painting studio.
Yeah. This whole get up here, the reason we didn't sandblast this, it's already ruined. Look, it's rusted through.
Yeah, look at that.
So this whole thing's getting ripped off.
All right, we're done.
Cool, thanks for your help.
You're welcome.
Well, I've got the tank in the garage, and now I need to get these fittings. I'm gonna see if I can get these fittings broke loose on top. The major one is this one over here. This big one over here, I'm getting rid of permanently. I don't have a reason for it. We didn't sandblast it because it's already rusted through in a lot of spots. So I just want to get it off, and we're actually going to plug that hole because I've got my fill here. This is my intake and return for fueling the generator, and this is my vent. So I don't need this here. So we're just going to take it off and plug it. I don't know. Let's see if we can get it done. Thank you. creative with that.
Get this gauge off there, get it out of my way.
Leverage on this. So I got the big white thing off the top here, but getting this off, oh my, I had to drill two big old holes. I ended up actually drilling three. But I drilled these two holes, and I've got a black pipe that I'm sticking through here, and I've actually been able to break it free. It was a bear. What a bear. Man, that was tough. All right, so I got to roll the tank onto its belly, or at least tip it enough to where I can paint the belly. So I got a rope here, and we're gonna tie off that large ratchet strap up to here. I'm gonna use the tractor to tip it, and hopefully I'll ratchet strap it and that will hold it. That's the plan. We'll be right back.
Okay, so the reason you see me take the cameras out is because I didn't even think about it, but they overspray. I don't know if you can see this. Look at the floor where the tarp was at and where the white is. So the overspray got all over my GoPro and my good camera that I use. And so I realized it partway through. I wanted to film this for you guys, but it's not worth ruining a camera over, so I took them outside. I wasn't able to film the rest of the painting, but here's the finished product I want to show you guys. We got a nice white tank. The ladder's all painted white. That was one tough job. What a mistake. In my wildest dreams, I would have never thought spraying that tank. I just didn't prepare for it, I guess I'd say. I came in here, I got excited, put the tank in here, and I got the paint together, got my sprayer together, and I wasn't even thinking in my mind about the spray, overspray getting everywhere. And I mean, let alone I didn't have the proper respirator and spraying it, that industrial paint like that was brutal. So needless to say, don't follow my lead. The job got done, but it was, there's just, the entire garage is dusted white across the entire floor. So, and I probably lost 5 years off my life sucking fumes. We finished it up, and this tank is gonna be super pivotal for us. It's gonna fuel our generator, possibly fuel our backup heat source. Anyways, so the tank's done. I'm super excited. We're gonna let it cure for a few days and then probably head over to Toke. I need to deliver this over there and get it staged. And we got a few things to bring to Toke. So my guess is we're gonna be headed to Toke here real soon. We appreciate you watching, appreciate the support. Thanks for stopping by and spending a little time with us. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up and I'll see you on the next one. Have a good day.
Okay, tell me when I'm in line with the tractor.
Okay. Okay. A little bit more. Good.
I wanted to back straight up, but I got a screw cattywampus.
Yeah.
Oh, well.